So I guess I'm gonna start with my eyes, and I'm gonna be using my new Sweet Peach palette by Too Faced. It's such a beautiful palette, and it has such a beautiful shades and eyeshadows. I absolutely love it, and I'm gonna try to create more of a natural look that you can wear every day, and yeah, we'll see what happens. I already primed my eyelid. I just used a concealer and a setting powder. I'm gonna take this shade right here and apply it all over my lid. Dripping lights, paint the skies, only you can make me move. You can make me move. Can make me move. You can make me move. Can make me. Make it last forever. Stop in time. Open eye, feel the waves cut through me. Hypnotized by the sounds I'm breathing in. Hold tight. So next, I'm just gonna curl my lashes and apply my new It Cosmetics Superhero mascara. This mascara I tried before and I absolutely love it, so I wanted to use it in this video because this is my new tube. I'm gonna apply it and I'll be right back. Now moving on to my face, and I'm gonna be using a new foundation that I got the other day. But I already, before I'm gonna start with my foundation, I already applied my primer. And my primer is the old primer, so I'm not gonna show you that. Foundation that I got the other day is this NYX Total Control foundation. It's a drop foundation. I have seen a lot of YouTubers raving about this foundation, and I am in the shade 04 Light Ivory. I'm gonna use this foundation and blend this with my just a beauty blender, okay? So let's start it. And I really don't know because this is very liquidy, like if you can see. So I have two drops in here and it's very light foundation. I'm gonna start with this side of my face and I'm just gonna apply. Oh, it's so light. Oh my god, it is very light foundation. But I'm not scared of very light foundation because I am very light and pale to begin with.
I just know that I can work with this because it's easier for me to bring the colors together or to bring the shade together if I use a little bit of a bronzer than make it or go like lighter if it's too dark for me. Well, I don't know if this is working for me. It's definitely very light coverage with one, like with one layer. It is so light. Like, I look so pale now. I am pale anyway, but it is like, it's definitely, if you can see this side of my face and this side of my face, this is definitely very pale and pinky comparing to this side of my face. Like, I thought I'm very pale, and I didn't know that they make this type of a foundation. Oh my god, I look like dead meat. I look like a ghost now. I do not like, honestly, I don't like this foundation. I don't like how it sits on my face either. Kind of how this powdery. Powdery look on me. I don't know why. I don't know if it's supposed to be like that. Alright, let me try to bring now this on the other side of my face and see if I can work with this. I look like a total ghost right now, so maybe if I would get a better shade or the shade that matches better my skin tone, I would maybe like this foundation, but right now, so far, I don't really like. I also don't like how it sits on my face, but this is what I'm gonna do because I do not like how it sits on my face and I don't like the shade of it, so I'm gonna go and apply a second layer of my L'Oreal Infallible Pro Glow foundation. I'm in Creamy Natural. I love the finish of this foundation. It has very natural glow finish, and I just know that this shade is perfect for me, and I like the finish of it because this is too pale. I didn't know that you can be more paler than what I am already, so I'll be right back after applying that L'Oreal foundation. So this is after I apply L'Oreal foundation, the Pro Glow foundation. I don't know about this foundation, there's something about it I don't like. The finish of it comes out very powdery, but it says over here on the package that with just a few drops, our Total Control Dry Foundation delivers sheer to full coverage and velvety matte finish. So it is a matte foundation. This foundation has like a powder finish. But anyway, moving on to my concealer. I will be using my all-time favorite concealer, this Maybelline Age Rewind concealer. I will be using my new Real Technique concealer sponge and see how it works with the concealer. And I do not like go heavy on my concealer. By the way, I'm in shade Fair, because as I said, I'm very fair. Fair skin tone. I have very fair skin tone. So now I'm just going to blend it in with my new Real Technique Beauty Blender. It's a concealer beauty blender. And it's a little bit damp, like almost dry damp. I love the sponge. I can tell it already because it is so small and it's so easy to get into this corners of the eyes with this pointy side. Also with this flat side, it's so easy to work around this areas. So I'm back. I did the rest of my face. The reason why I didn't show you how I apply my bronzer and my highlighter is because they're old products and there's nothing to talk about them. So on my cheeks, as a bronzer, I use this Laura Geller Baked Impressions bronzer. This is water resistant matte bronzer in shade light, and I just applied it on my forehead and like kind of contour with this. And for my cheeks, for blush, since we're on the peachy side, I use this Milani's blush, Luminoso. Everybody knows this. I always use this. I love this shade. It's very peachy. I absolutely adore this blush. I love all blushes by Milani. I think they're very good quality. Now, since I'm done with my face, with my eyes, I'm gonna do the last product, and last step is my lips. And I will be using new lippies by ColourPop with collaboration with Kathleen Lights. So I swatched all of those three lipsticks on back of my hand. So I'm gonna start from this one. This is the lip gloss. If you can see, they're all in the same shade. They're Aquarius. This is a lip gloss. This is a matte lipstick, and it's not dry yet, but once it's dry, it's matte. And this one is satin. I absolutely love all three of them. I think it looks very beautiful on any skin tone. But today I'm just gonna use this shade right here, Aquarius shade. It's beautiful pinky nude lip gloss, and it's not a sheer lip gloss. It's actually very opaque. And this one right here, let me open it and show you. This is the shade in the tube, and I'm gonna just apply it to my lips. As I said, this lip gloss is very opaque, so I'm gonna try now. I absolutely love the lip gloss. I'll be honest, out of all three lippies, I like the gloss the most. I just like glosses in general, but I think the gloss shade, the lip gloss shade, is the most appealing to me. It's my favorite color, and I think it's gonna be one of my go-to lip glosses that I will use on a daily basis. This is my final look. I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial and my first impressions video. I absolutely like all of the products that I've used today, except for one. This foundation right here is just, it didn't work with my skin, and I didn't like the finish of it. I didn't like how it stays on my skin, so probably this will go back to the store, and I will have to either change the shade because the shade was way too light for me, or just exchange it to something else because I really do not like this foundation. Other than that, the lippies are absolutely my favorite. I love the lip gloss, and I absolutely love the rest of the lipsticks. My sponge, concealer, my peach palette is the most favorite one. I absolutely love this palette. It's such a beautiful palette with such a beautiful shade. So this is it for today. I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you do like this video, please don't forget to hit the like button. And if you're new to my channel, please don't forget to subscribe. I hope you will subscribe to my channel. It means a lot to me. And I'll see you on my next video. Bye!